Good morning, students. Already we discussed equation of the chord, equation of the tangent, equation of the normal, parametric equation of the parabola. With the help of that parametric equation, we are converting equation of the tangent at t, equation of the normal at t. Then condition for the line y equal to mx plus c to be a tangent to the parabola, and also for the ellipse and also for the hyperbola, all these theoretical concepts to be worked out. And one more, two tangents can be drawn from any point to the parabola y squared equal to 4x. The same concept is also applicable for an ellipse and also for hyperbola. All these theoretical concepts we already worked out. By using this concept, we are having one proof. Read the question. This is one of the important logic. The locus of, what is the meaning of locus? Well-known procedure. The path traced by a moving point. So that we are going to find out the locus. The locus of point of intersection of the perpendicular tangents. The locus of point of intersection of the perpendicular tangents to the parabola y squared equal to 4ax is x equal to minus a. Read the question, then we have to draw the diagram. After that, it is a very simple concept. The locus of point of intersection of the perpendicular tangents to the parabola y squared equal to 4ax is x equal to minus a. What is the meaning of x equal to minus a? We can say it is x plus a equal to 0. See the basic definitions. It is nothing but directrix. So we need point of intersection of the perpendicular tangents. Yesterday itself we derived point of intersection. So from that point of intersection, if the two tangents, yesterday we worked out point of intersection, if the two tangents intersecting at right angles, that is called perpendicular tangents, then that point of intersection lies on the directrix. That is nothing but the locus of the point of intersection should be on the directrix. We are going to work out this concept. Read the question. I am going to draw the diagram first. What is the meaning behind this? Yesterday itself we worked out 90%. Today, one more logic. See the parabola. Standard equation we are taking. So this is the standard equation. That means y squared equal to 4ax. Now listen. So point of intersection of the tangents. Now listen. I am taking one tangent here. Then I am taking one more tangent here. So this is another tangent. So these two tangents intersecting at one point. Yesterday we have worked out this concept. This is called point of intersection. This point of intersection yesterday we worked out. But today they are asking, if the two tangents are at right angles, that is called the perpendicular tangents. If the two tangents are at right angles, then this point of intersection, we need to find the locus. Locus of this point P should be directrix, that is x equal to minus a. That is the logic we are going to work out. See the concept. This is tangent number 1. This is tangent number 2. These two tangents are intersecting at one point. Listen now the concept. If the tangents are perpendicular, then the locus of this point, locus means it should be a moving point, locus of this point is directrix, that is x equal to minus a, or you can say x plus a equal to 0. Now, the listen the concept. It is one of the very important derivation we have to understand. Yesterday we find out the point of intersection. Now today, after that point of intersection, we are going to find the locus of that point. That should be, if the tangents are perpendicular, then the point of intersection of the locus is x equal to minus a. Now listen, we are taking equations of the two tangents, but the point is not given. Here point, there is no point. So already we know the procedure. Y equal to mx plus a by m is also the equation of the tangent, where m is the slope. We already worked out the theoretical concept. So if the point is given, that is said to be equation of the tangent at the x1 comma y1. But here there is no point. So we can take y equal to mx plus c. Instead of c, the condition is a by m. So this derivation we already worked out. So now equation of the tangent, y equal to mx plus c, equation of the tangent. Listen, equation of the tangent, y equal to mx plus a by m. Now this tangent passing through the point, say the point is x1 comma y1. Initially I am taking the point x1 comma y1. So this equation passing through, this equation passing through P of x1 comma y1. So we can substitute that value. Now y1 equal to mx1 plus a by m. So this equation is multiplied by m. We can get my1 is equal to m squared x1 plus a. Convert into the same side, we can get m squared x1 minus my1 plus a equal to 0. Up to this level, we already worked out in a theoretical portion. So, equation of the tangent, y equal to mx plus a by m. Why we are selecting this one? There is no point is given. Instead of the point, suppose point is not given, instead of the at x1 comma y1, we can select y equal to mx plus a by m is also the equation of the tangent to the parabola y squared equal to 4ax. This equation passing through the point p of x1 comma y1, I am substituting this one, I can get y1 equal to mx1 plus a by m. To avoid the denominator m, multiplication with m, we can get m squared x1 minus my1 plus a equal to 0. Now this is a quadratic equation in m. By solving this equation, we can get two values of m. Say m1 and m2. Say m1 and m2. So this concept already we derived. This is a quadratic equation in M. You can write the explanation. It is a quadratic equation in M. By solving this equation, we can get two values of M, say M1 and M2. From your lower standard, from your 10th standard onwards, you know this concept. Sum of the roots. In your 10th standard, you are using alpha plus beta. Sum of the roots, alpha plus beta. What is the formula? Minus b by a. Instead of alpha plus beta, we are having m1 and m2 as the solutions. Therefore, m1 plus m2 is equal to minus of, what is the value of b here? It is a quadratic equation in m. This is said to be a, this is said to be b. Already minus y1. Therefore, minus y1 divided by the value of a must be x1. Therefore, m1 plus m2 is equal to y1 divided by x1. This is said to be sum of the roots. And also from this equation, we are able to work out the product of the roots. Now listen, product of the roots. So product of the roots. That is nothing but alpha beta. What is the formula? C by A. Here, what is the meaning of alpha beta? We are saying M1 and M2 the roots. Therefore, instead of alpha beta, we can say m1 m2 equal to c by a. What is the value of c here? This is a. What is the value of a? x1. So this is to be product. So from this quadratic equation, we are able to work out two roots, m1 and m2. From that sum of the roots, m1 plus m2 equal to minus b by a, use that concept, we are getting this result. Then the product of the roots, m1, m2 equal to a divided by x1. Now see the diagram. Now we need diagrammatic explanation. See this one. Now, the tangents are perpendicular. If two lines are said to be perpendicular, then what is the relation? Product of their slopes equal to minus 1. So, the tangents are perpendicular. So, tangents are perpendicular. So, the point of intersection at P of x and comma y1, now this angle must be 90 degrees. That is said to be perpendicular. If tangents are perpendicular, then product of their slopes equal to minus 1. Therefore, m1 into m2 equal to minus 1. Therefore, instead of this m1, m2, I am substituting minus 1. Therefore, minus 1 equal to a divided by x1. Now, cross multiplying, minus x1 equal to a. From this, I can write x1 equal to minus a. x1 equal to minus a. We need the locus. It should be a fixed point. If the locus means intersection P of x1 comma y1, we need to find the locus, then the x1 becomes x. Therefore, locus of P of x1 comma y1 is, here it is a fixed value, x1 equal to a. But we need the locus. Locus means it should be the path traced by a moving point. Therefore, instead of x1, I am selecting x equal to a. So, I can write x plus a equal to 0. It represents the equation of the directrix. So, it is an important question. So, read the concept. What is the given? Point of intersection of the perpendicular tangents. So, that is the concept. So, we have locus of point of intersection of this perpendicular tangents is x equal to minus a, or we can say x plus a equal to 0. Now listen the concept. This is tangent number 1, this is tangent number 2. These two tangents intersecting at P of x1 comma y1. So we need to find the point of intersection of this point. Then select equation of the tangent. What is the equation of the tangent? Y equal to mx plus a by m. So where m is the slope. Then after that, simplifying that equation, we can get quadratic equation in M. Then say, it is a quadratic equation in M, we can get two values of M, say M1 and M2. Then find the sum of the slopes, that is M1 plus M2, product of the slopes M1 into M2. From that, we can get the product of the roots M1, M2 equal to a by x1. Then you have the concept here. These tangents intersecting at right angles. That means product of their slopes must be minus 1. Substitute here, simplify. We can get locus of the point P of x1 comma y1 is, here we are getting x1. Use the word locus. Locus means it should be a moving point. Then x equal to minus a. We can say x plus a equal to 0. It is the equation of the directrix. In the same logic, we are taking the parabola here. In the same model, you have one question, that is for an ellipse. Understand the same type of question. The locus of point of intersection of the perpendicular tangents to the parabola we already worked out. Instead of the parabola, we are going to select the ellipse. That is the only change. See this. The locus of point of intersection of the perpendicular tangents. Locus of point of intersection of the perpendicular tangents to an ellipse. Like the standard equation of ellipse, x squared by a squared plus y squared by b squared equal to 1. We are going to derive all these derivation part on the standard equation. So perpendicular tangents to an ellipse, x squared by a squared plus y squared by b squared equal to 1, is x squared plus y squared equal to a squared plus b squared. The name of this is a circle, because you are adding a square plus b square, we can get a constant only. So x square plus y square equal to constant, it should be an ellipse. The name of this, sorry, circle, the name of this circle is director circle. This is the name is director circle of an ellipse, director circle of an ellipse. It is ellipse, it is circle. So x square plus y square equal to a square plus b square, it should be a constant. Therefore, x square plus y square equal to r square formation, it should be a director circle, the name of this director circle of an ellipse. Hey students, locus of point of intersection of the perpendicular tangents to an ellipse, x squared by a squared plus y squared b squared equal to 1, is x squared plus y squared equal to a squared plus b squared. We have to prove this result. The name of this is called director circle. Now listen, what is the diagrammatic explanation of an ellipse? Already well known derivation. This is the standard equation. It is nothing but the standard equation given ellipse. Given ellipse. What is the standard equation? X squared by a squared plus y squared by b squared equal to 1. Now take the standard diagram, that is type number 1. So x squared, sorry, x axis, y axis, center must be origin 0, 0. Now we are going to draw two tangents. That two tangents must be intersect at right angles. Then we need to find the locus. Now listen, I am taking a tangent here. I am taking a tangent. Again one more tangent. Draw one more tangent. So tangent number 1, tangent number 2. This is one tangent, this is another tangent. Tangent, again tangent. These two tangent intersecting at P of x1 comma y1. Then we need to find the locus of the point of intersection of this tangent. It should be a perpendicular. Then we are able to get a circle. That circle must be so draw the circle, the locus of the point of intersection of the perpendicular tangents must be a circle. We can get a circle here. Draw clearly, we can get. So this is the logic they're asking. We are going to prove. It should be a circle. Now listen, this is the point of intersection. So this must be a point of intersection of the perpendicular tangents meeting at P of x1, y1. See this one. This is the point of intersection. Then the locus of this point of intersection must be a circle. So the logic already we worked out. See, we can draw two tangents to the ellipse. We already worked out. Then what is the formula? Y equal to mx plus or minus square root of a squared m squared plus b squared. This is the equation of the tangent. Equation of the tangent. Here also no information about the point, given point. Here at, so at the point is not given. Therefore we can select equation of the tangent y equal to mx plus or minus square root of a squared m squared plus b squared. This tangent intersecting, that means passing through the point P of x1 comma y1. This equation passing through, this equation passing through P of x1 comma y1. If an equation passing through a particular point, we can substitute here. Then y1 equal to m x1 plus or minus square root of a squared m squared plus b squared. So I am converting that root family one side, another side here. So I can write here y1 minus mx1 equal to plus or minus square root of a squared m squared plus b squared. To avoid this root, squaring both sides. To avoid this root, squaring both sides, we can get y1 minus mx1 the whole squared equal to, then if you are squaring, then plus or minus symbol will be removed, roots should be removed. Therefore, we can get a squared m squared plus b squared. A squared m squared plus b squared. Now, listen to this concept. Equation of the tangent, y equal to mx plus or minus. We already derived this proof. This tangent passing through the point P of x1, y1. Then substitute instead of x, y. So we can get y1 equal to mx1 plus or minus root of a squared plus m squared. This equation, we are rearranging y1 minus mx1 equal to plus or minus root of a squared m squared plus b squared. To avoid the root family, y1 minus mx1 the whole squared, it will be. Then expand this one, we can get to y1 squared plus m squared x1 squared minus 2m x1 y1 equal to a squared m squared plus b squared. See this? It is in the form of a minus b the whole squared. Expand y1 squared m squared x1 squared minus 2m x1 y1. Now here we are having x squared family, sorry, m squared family. Here also m squared family. Convert in the same side. M squared x1 squared minus a squared m squared minus 2m x1 y1. Then already we are having one more y1 squared minus b squared equal to 0. Take m squared from this. So from this we can take m squared. The remaining is x1 squared minus a squared minus 2m x1 y1. Then the constant should be y1 squared minus b squared equal to 0. Listen this concept. Here we are having a quadratic equation. When we are expanding this one, we can get y1 squared, m squared, x1 squared, minus 2m, x1, y1. In your RHS side, a squared, m squared, plus b squared. We are having 2m squared. Take in one side, m squared, x1 squared, minus a squared, m squared. The remaining m is 2m, x1, y1. The remaining is y1 squared, minus b squared. So consider m squared as a common, the remaining is x1 squared minus a squared, 2m x1 y1 plus y1 squared minus b squared. Consider this is a quadratic equation in m. By solving this equation we can get two values of m, say m1 and m2. All the concepts are the remaining is same as per the parabola. Here it is a quadratic equation in m. Solving this equation we can get two values of m, say m1 and m2. Now what is the meaning of sum of the roots? Just now we explained m1 plus m2, that is sum. The formula is minus b by a, but this result is not wanted. The reason is we need the perpendicular. So I am taking m1 m2 product, that is product. So what is the product of the roots? Formula c by a. Now listen, what is the value of c here? So m1 m2 is equal to, what is the value of c? C must be this constant, y1 squared minus b squared divided by, what is the value of a? X1 squared minus a squared. Here, the perpendicular tangents means the product of the slope must be minus 1. Therefore, instead of this, I am using minus 1. That is the logic in the previous question we discussed it. So, product of the slope must be minus 1 since the tangents are perpendicular. Therefore, y1 squared minus b squared divided by x1 squared minus a squared. Then cross multiply, you can get the proof. These are very important theoretical concepts. Dear students, you have to observe and work out yourself. So use the basic knowledge. Then cross multiply, you can get minus x1 squared. Because it is multiplication with the negative 1, we can get minus x1 squared minus of minus plus a squared equal to, in your RHS side you can get y squared minus b squared. See, just to cross multiply this one, minus x1 squared plus a squared, already y1 squared plus b squared. Interchange this x1 and y1. I am taking this x1 and a squared here. Therefore a squared plus b squared equal to, converting this one, x1 squared plus y1 squared. We need to find the locus of this point. Therefore the locus of P of x1 comma y1 is, we have to find the locus, it should be x squared plus y squared. Instead of x1, y1, we need to find the locus, then x1, y1 becomes x squared plus y squared equal to a squared plus b squared. So see the circle, this one, this is called director circle. We draw the circle perfectly, you can draw it. So the locus of P of x1, y1 is x squared plus y squared equal to a squared plus b squared. It is nothing but the equation of the circle. The name of the circle is director circle. So dear student, all the basic concept are refer your parabola. Just instead of the parabola, you can select the equation of the tangent, that is y equal to mx plus r minus square root of a squared plus a squared m squared plus b squared. After that, the procedures are same. Then try yourself up to this level. Thank you.